Yogesh from Implant Air, and to be very frank, this is our first attempt to connect with Canada in our country. So I just want to have a quick run with what we are and what we do. Then I'll talk on my subject, so maybe a couple of minutes. So we are Implant Air. We are located in Mysore. We design product, solve problems for the people and the companies. I'll just browse through this. So our idea is to see how we can make smaller, more effective, and better products. So we were the pioneer in few of the things. Were smallest active RFID tag, which is goes to Indian Navy as defense in a lot of companies in India. When the iPhone did not have the fingerprint scanner, we were the people who designed the case with the fingerprint. This is a smart toy for kids. It's not a phone. It is very specific to the kids for the storytelling. This is for the UK police, which will very soon be inducted in UK for crowd management, riot controls. It's very precise. It doesn't harm the individuals. This is a hydration pack monitor, which actually measures the amount of water left in your hydration pack when you are in cycling or mountaineering. There is currently no way we can measure that. This measures it with a lot of combination, and it gives you an alert on the app. And various systems like for the agriculture, for the this right side, the system it is installed in Rolls-Royce factory right now for the fumes extraction in the manufacturing. This is a smart bed system. Probably I should run through that because we have is going to be launched in July, and various products. So these are the customers. So this is the introduction of Implant Air. Now this is what I came here to talk. So since last 1 year, since we are getting mature, we also wanted to do something which can have an impact. So we chose two areas. One is the healthcare. So for that, we have a small, maybe we will not call it as an incubator because, you know, it doesn't fit the FDA approvals. So we just call it as a baby monitor. It's called Joy. So we are in the advanced stage of doing that. Other than that, the other area was agriculture. When we say about agriculture, we think about food. But I don't think that the entire world, when we take about the landmass in which we are growing, do we really grow food which goes into the human stomach directly? We grow the fodder, we grow cotton, we grow crops which are actually not feeding us. In order to grow them in the more unhuman way, we put a lot of pesticides, a lot of fertilizers, which is actually depleting the groundwater, which is spoiling the groundwater, lead content, mercury content. So the idea was, how do we tackle this indirectly? So this project which we are doing is a combination with a venture called Food Future, which is having a partnership with MIT Media Lab, University of Arizona. And we from India, and then there are various companies which are involved. But basically, right now, it has a very simple non-profit goal that how do we actually tackle this problem. So the problem was, we will not directly tell farmer that I'll help you with better seed or something, because there are everybody doing that. So we thought, let us take out these crop which are not going into human stomach, and let us make them as an industry. Let us put it as a manufacturing. So the track is like, can we solve it directly or indirectly? In order to have it as a manufacturing, you need to have it as a full process. So right from planting the seed, why do we need a land-based growing? Can we have it greenhouse? Why do we even need greenhouse? I think we should have it as a multi-layer vertical farming. If it is vertical farming, what are the challenges? What are the ways we have to control the things? Okay, we need carbon dioxide because we are putting artificial lighting, we are putting LED lighting. LED lighting has its own challenges, like heat generation. Can I use a heat for making carbon dioxide? Can I use that carbon dioxide when the photosynthesis rate is more? So it is a complete cycle now which we are working on. And we have mastered 80% of that. I will not use the word mastered. But yes, we are trying to tackle it in a more better way than what we were tackling in the previous time. So there are actuators which will actually release the carbon dioxide. We generate the carbon dioxide which is required when the photosynthesis is happening. And at the same time, now we are getting into the machine learning, And we are trying to see if we can use the IBM Watson for that. Again, since we were never connected to the universities and the institutes, so the only way we chose was to getting into the already people who have a products. So again, I spoke about implanter. The only thing which I may not have spoken is like we have helped companies to generate more than 60 patents in the last 10 years. And why we are in Mysore? Because it is the cleanest city of India. It is one of the most green city of India. And it's very ideal for small companies. We can innovate. We don't waste time in traffic. We reach office in 10 minutes. And people know us. If we visit places regularly, it is proximity to Bangalore. And again, we do not have the issues of Bangalore. So right now, my purpose of coming here is to give this message at the same time to see if we can collaborate with you. Probably since it was a small introduction about what we are and what we do. So is there any chance where this is a great thing which can work, because you know whatever technologies we speak about, right from the actuation, right from the seed planting, as you spoke, picking the cotton, cleaning the cotton, right from fertigation, even the humidity management, climate control, these are the separate things now which we had already designed. Now we are trying to integrate it to see if it goes into the vertical farming of maybe 100 feet, how we can have 12 layers, how we can reuse the water, and how we can use the solar, how we can use the biomass. So we are trying to integrate this together. So definitely we need a lot of collaboration, and I'm just open for that, and I can be contacted after the talk. Thank you.